Det er det. Det tror jeg, den er. I just put myself on mute.
Hello and welcome everybody. On behalf of Team Sauerland, a very warm welcome. It's great to be back in Herning with the Nordic Fight Night. And also the Viking warrior, Mikkel Kessler, is back in Herning on December 8th in this beautiful new arena. Jyske Bank Boxen, he will face Brian McGee, who joins us here with his manager, Pat McGee, for the WBA Super Middleweight World Championship. And we are here to kick off this promotion and answer all questions. And we are also joined by Georg Sørensen, the director of MCH. Kalle, first question to you. Brian McGee has, done some business in Denmark already. He has stopped Mads Larsen, he has stopped Rudy Markussen, and now he wants to complete his hat-trick. So this really is a question of honor for Mikkel.
Good afternoon, everyone, first of all. Look, we've had a, while all of you have been enjoying your summer holidays, I've been busy looking for the next steps for Mikkel. I know a lot of the media have been calling me on a, I wouldn't even say daily, but hourly basis for updates. What's come out of it is something that I think is going to be a very, very special event. Pat McGee is a very hard negotiator. But at the end of the day, we both wanted the fight, and I'd have to say I give full credit to Brian McGee, who could very easily have also taken other big fights, knowing that he could always say, well, I beat the two other best guys in Denmark, and I think it's a big credit that he's sitting next to me here today. And I think it's going to be a great fight. You know, I know there's a lot of storylines, you know, the question of honor. If anyone knows about the Sauerland history in Germany, it comes from an event from very early in the 90s or the mid 90s from Henry Masker, Rocky Gianni at the time, which was one of the biggest events in German history. And you know, I thought it was a very fitting motto for this. I mean, it's a world super middleweight championship fight. There's not an interim fight like some have been, some mistakenly reported. It's confirmed by the WBA. This is for the full super middleweight world championship. And we will, have a lot of storylines. There's a lot of storylines, not just the storylines, of course, that this is a question of Mikkel taking revenge for his countrymen, or Mikkel becoming world champion for a record fourth time. But this is, at the end of the day, down to two great athletes who will stand across the ring from each other. And then it won't be talking about any more stories. It will just be man against man, and that's, at the end of the day, the nicest thing in boxing.
Thank you, Kalle. Brian, you opened the Nordic Fight Night with a victory over Rudy Markussen, and you've proven your heart and your class as a champion to travel abroad and clinch some spectacular victories. What do you think of fighting here in this beautiful arena and take on Mikkel Kessler on December 8th?
Yeah, it's been here in the arena, actually seen it firsthand. It's an amazing arena. It will be, it'll be a fantastic night for me. This will be the highlight probably of my career, fighting such a great champion as Mikkel. You know, I've watched him as a whole boxing career, so I'm actually a big fan of Mikkel. So actually being and actually fighting him and fighting him for the world title, it's a big honor for me. So everybody wants to be a world champion, and that includes me. And that's why I'm still fighting and fighting so hard. So I'm looking forward to the fight. Come back to Denmark. All the fans have treated me so well, and all the promoters here have treated me so well so far. So we're very, very welcome to come back to Denmark to fight again, because the last two times has been a fantastic experience, and hopefully this time will be just the same. Fingers crossed.
Mikkel, you come off a spectacular victory against Alan Green at Parken. What has your summer been like? And I guess you've been training the whole time, basically.
Yeah. Yes, I've been training a lot. I've been on a vacation too. I feel good. You know, it's awkward for me fighting two times a year, and have no injuries. So it's a new thing for me, and that's why I still have a very good shape. Of course, I had some vacation, but I kept my training, and I didn't have to go 1 year to get a new fight. And of course, it's a big honor for me to to fight McGee. I had him as a sparring partner once. Very nice guy. You can't get mad at him. But I know when the bell rings, we're not friends.
Thank you very much, Mikael. Pat, question for you. You know Brian better than anybody else. What do you think will he win on December 8?
Well, of course, a big advantage for us is having been in Denmark twice before and had very good wins, which is the reason we're here today. I mean, Brian, and there, as Kalla mentioned earlier, there has been some confusion over what position Brian holds in the WBA. The position which Brian holds in the WBA is he's the number one contender, he's the interim champion, and since I won the purse bids for him to fight the previous champion, Carly Balzai, who has since retired due to illness, this fight is for the vacant regular WBA title. Now, on the night, it's a question of whether Brian walks into the ring as the champion or whether he's walking into the ring as equal to Mikkel Kessler in a vacant title fight. That is yet to be decided. But one thing for certain is that the fight is for the WBA regular title. And I'd just like to say that when Brian became the mandatory challenger for the title, and when we had the opportunity of deciding whom Brian would box for the title, we were informed by the WBA that Brian could have picked anyone in the top 15 of the WBA ratings or anyone who would qualify for a world title fight. And at that stage, we drew up a select list, and the top of the list, would you believe, and Brian's first choice was Mikkel Kessler. Because, you know, he felt himself that this was the fight which would raise him to the standards that he always wanted. So it's not a question of Kalla Sauerland luring us to Denmark. We picked coming to Denmark. It's true that negotiations have taken a long time, but I mean that's my job, and I think we've got.
And you do it well.
we've got a great fight here. I think that the Danish fans are going to see something that is something special, and I hope that the arena will be filled out on the night. And certainly, our first impressions of the arena are, you know, we think it's just absolutely wonderful. It's something we didn't expect. We didn't know that this was the arena, by the way, and I can remember back when Mikkel boxed and beat Carl Froch, and of course the British press were somewhat miffed about that result. The arena where that fight was held was called a shed, and I think this cannot be called a shed. We will have no excuses. This is the type of arena that Brian wants to box in, and this gives us a lift. And Brian will be ready. Brian will be ready on the night, and we're looking forward to December 8th.
And I'm looking forward to the golf holiday in Ireland that Pat promised me for next year. Just a real quick one to the choice of arena. There is a little storyline which I think George you'll talk about in a second. It was of course as always a difficult decision. There are one or two other major venues in Denmark, but at the end of the day, we planned. A long time ago, there's I think even some pictures, George, where George took me in and said, Kalla, we're going to have in 1 year this place finished and it's going to look like the O2 World in Berlin or in Hamburg. And I said, I went away, I said, oh, George, very impressive, you know. But when I walked away, I thought, this guy's nuts, you know. I said, there's no way that this place is going to look like this in 1 year. And 1 year later, I was sitting with Mikkel a few rows behind us here, and we were at the Lady Gaga concert. And I said, Christ, this guy actually has managed to build this arena in this space of time. It is one hell of a place. And I think it is the first boxing event in Jyske Bank Boxing. And I think there's no more fitting event than this. And we could, if we, I think if we were standing there those years ago, if we would have put a Hollywood script to it. This is it, and you know we're looking forward to christening the arena.
Well, it was certainly two special fights we had here in Herning already, against Perdomo with Mikkel and against Frotch, and the atmosphere was fantastic the last time. But in this new arena, I guess it will be even better. George.
Hopefully. And you're right, Kellen. It was a dream. Now the dream come through. We are ready. Jyske Bank Boxing is ready for McGee and for Mikkel Kessler. And it is the third time you are here again, Mikkel. And you are on your home ground again. You have been a little away, but as Kellen said, it was in the plan that you would come back. So thanks for that to both of you. Also to the family McGee, a warm welcome to you. Yep. We'll be ready for you also. Thank you. So to hosting such a world-class event is a part of the plan. We have, as Kellen mentioned, we opened the 20th of October 2010 with the big Lady Gaga show. And next month we have 2 years anniversary. So we have had shows, we had top music, top handball, the championships, and now also world-class boxing. And that's very important for me to understate that that is a part of the plan. Now the dream will come through, and personally, I look very forward to see Mikkel Kessler versus McGee, because the historical match in Hall M in 2010, you might remember it. You wrote about it, and you said it to us, the team of the press, the best match ever on Danish ground. So now we are back, all of us. I look forward to a hopefully good and intense match between two of the best boxers in the world. Thank you.
And I might add that the tickets go on sale on Monday morning, I believe at 10 a.m. on biletnet.dk. And let's see how many people will make this a real spectacle this time out. Are there any questions before we go on with the one-on-one interviews? No questions? Then I would suggest we take two face-to-face pictures. We'll do one over here, and we'll do one inside in the middle of the arena. Okay, let's do another one. Any preferences? Which one?
Yeah, I don't know. Hvad kan vi lige skylde? Skal det ikke næsten være? Jo, jo. Uden den baggrund, så den.
Er det det?
Nej, lige ikke om det. Ja, sådan der. Flot. Og lige her også. Tak.
Nå, der var tale om flere mulige modstandere, så blev det Brian McGee. Hvad siger du til, at det bliver ham?
Meget glad. Meget glad for, at han vil møde mig. Til den her kamp, han kunne have mødt nogen, der ikke var så gode som mig, kan man sige. Og tage den lette vej til at blive verdensmester. Men han ved godt, at han skal gå den hårde vej. Og det er jeg glad for. Jeg er glad for, at han har valgt mig. Jeg er glad for, at jeg kan bokse ham ved verdensmesterskabet igen. Så jeg kan ikke være mere end tilfreds.
Brian McGee har jo både slået Mads Larsen og Rudi Markussen. Der bliver snakket lidt om, han er sådan en dansker dræber. Hvad siger du så til, at der er den forhistorie?
Ja, dansker dræber. Mads Larsen var skadet, ikke? Og Rudi havde hans forberedelser, var ikke særlig gode. Så jeg ved det nu ikke, men det beviser jo lidt, at jeg bare skal, at man ikke skal tage det for givet. Brian McGee, han kommer med alt, hvad han har. Og man skal være der 100%. Man skal træne op 100%. Man skal ikke have nogen småskader. Der skal ikke være noget i vejen. Så vinder man ikke. Han er der, og han er dygtig, og han er udspekuleret. Meget flink mand, bortset fra det. Rigtig rar fyr, faktisk. Man kan sige, at han spiller sin kort rigtigt, du ved. Og han glæder sig bare til at bokse over. Og det er stort for ham også. Og så bokse mod mig. Så det kan også sætte ham videre i systemet. Så han gør alt for, jeg ved, han kommer med alt, hvad han har. Alt hans boksekunde og noget. Så det bliver spændende.
Men er der også et element af hævn så? Fordi du skal hævne, at han har slået både Mads og Rudi?
Ja, selvfølgelig skal det. Han skal da ikke kalde sig danskerdræberen, vel? Det går jo ikke. Så må vi jo lige vise ham, at det går altså ikke. Når nu stopper lejen. Han skal ikke have noget hat-trick, som de gik og snakke om.
Men du har haft ham som sparringspartner før, så du kender ham også rent boksemæssigt. Hvordan er han i forhold til dig? Din stil og sådan noget?
Det er svært at sige. Nu sparer jeg med ham her for 5-6 år siden, ikke? Til Galsakke-kampen. Jeg tror, sparer med ham i 3 dage, og han ikke var særlig meget i form. Så han gik slet ikke fremad på det tidspunkt. Det er det eneste, jeg husker. Men alle de kampe, jeg har set, går han fremad. Så han er måske ikke ligesom han var i træningslokalet, som han er i ringen. Så han er svær. Det gik meget godt dengang, kan jeg huske. Men han kom i ikke så god form, og jeg var i mit livs bedste form. Også dengang.
Sidste gang vi så dig, der var det, hvor du knockoutede Alan Green i parken. Spektakulært knockout og sådan noget. Hvordan har du så forberedt dig siden den kamp?
Jamen, jeg har jo bare haft noget ferie og slappet af og fået trænet lidt. Og så at man kan få den her kamp, det var ikke sikkert. Det var en masse på listen, der var mange, der ikke kunne. Og at Brian McGee, han lige pludselig hopper ind og gerne vil have den her kamp, det er jo helt fantastisk for mig. Jeg var vant til at bokse en gang om året, den sidste par år, så jeg er glad for, at jeg skal bokse allerede nu, og det betyder også, at jeg har en grundform, som er helt anderledes end sidste år.
Men den Alan Green-kamp der, hvordan ser du tilbage på den nu her? Altså, kan du bruge den fremadrettet og sige, okay, du har tanket noget selvtillid, fordi det var et ret flot kamp af dig?
Jo, men selvfølgelig kan jeg også lære mig meget. Det, der er godt, det er, at jeg fik en kamp, kan man sige, at jeg kom i ringen. Det er nok det vigtigste, i stedet for, at der er gået et helt år igen. Og det er godt, der ikke går så lang tid, i stedet for, at vi altid skal vente derovre. Så der kun går et halvt år. Det er bedre. Det er også bedre, at man får nogle pauser, så kan man komme i gang igen. Så passer det hele. Og det passer også med ens grundform. Rigtig godt. Passer rigtig godt til mig. Og man har hygget sig, og man har trænet lidt og holdt sig i form hele sommeren. Og nu bliver det vinter, jamen, så skal vi i gang igen. Det er også det, jeg har været vant til før i tiden.
Jeg ved godt, at man som bokser kun tager én kamp ad gangen. Men hvis eller når du vinder over McGee her, så står du som første udfordrer til en Andre Ward-kamp. Hvordan ser du på den?
Jamen selvfølgelig vil jeg gerne møde ham, og han har da også undgået mig meget, lad mig sige det sådan. Men han må også komme lidt væk fra Oakland, jo. Men ellers må man jo bare sætte det over igen. Så må man bare have tjekke alt ud med dommerne og så videre. Men jeg har ikke tænkt så meget over det, altså. Man er altså bort i baghovedet lortekamp. Ikke fordi han var meget bedre på aftenen, synes jeg ikke. Han gjorde nogle ting, og der er masser af ting, han fik lov til, men jeg var nødt til at tænke mod Brian McGee nu. Ligesom det er svært at tænke på næste kamp. Jeg skal bokse om verdensmesterskabet. Så skal man ikke begynde at tænke, når jeg vinder. Det er godt, du siger, når jeg vinder, for det er ikke noget, hvis jeg vinder. Det er når jeg vinder nemlig. Så skal man ikke lige tænke bagefter, så skal jeg møde. Fordi lige meget, hvordan du vinder og drejer, så skal du ikke begynde at tænke på en anden modstander, når der er én modstander her. Man skal begynde at træne, så kan jeg sige, så skal jeg lige møde Ward, og så skal jeg møde Brian McGee. Det bliver en hård, og det bliver en, han er stærkere ved at komme alt, hvad han har. Al sin boksekunde. Så jeg ved, at det bliver en rigtig hård kamp. Og så, når jeg har vundet den kamp, som det skal hedde, så kan du spørge mig om Ward bagefter.
Nu står vi her i den her Jyske Bank Boksen Arena her. Hvordan tror du, det bliver at gå ind her til boksekamp?
Fantastisk. Det er jo en flot arena. Jeg kan ikke anklage, jeg har været her før til nogle koncerter, og hvordan nu har jeg set tegningen, hvordan de vil stille det op med boksringen ude i midten, og hvordan de kan lave alt. Så det er, jeg synes, det er, ja, jeg glæder mig rigtig meget. Også til at bokse et helt nyt sted, hvor jeg ikke har bokset.
Okay. Jeg kan også lige spørge dig to spørgsmål på engelsk til vores ikke dansk talende seere.
Ja.
Okay. How is it now that you are going to fight Brian McGee?
How is it now? What do you mean?
What do you think of meeting Brian McGee?
To fight Brian McGee is a big opportunity for me because he holds he have the WBA as a first contender and he chose me to fight him for the WBA championship. So it's a big deal for me. It's great for me to have this opportunity for the WBA title again. And I hope, of course, to bring it home to Denmark.
And the last fight, you were knocking out Alan Green in Parken. How have your preparations been to this fight now?
My preparations has been good. I'm gonna have to start my preparation, my serious hard preparations for McGee, and for Alan Green in Parken had very good preparations, but now I didn't have 1 year of getting off boxing and hold my shape, so now I have a better standard shape for this fight, a better condition. I've only been away four months for my last fight, so I'll be ready for this one. So it's good it's not been a year and only 6 months.
Okay. There's been a lot of names in the talking of who will be the next next fight for Mikkel Kessler. Now it's Brian McGee. Why do you think that that's going to be a good fight?
Well, first of all, there were a lot of names mentioned. I would say half the names were never really possibilities. You know, some people talked about an Andre Ward fight. Andre Ward just boxed, so that was not an option for us. You know, Brian McGee brings the opportunity to box for the world title. Along with that, it brings a lot of very interesting storylines. You know, the fact that he's beaten the two other big Danish names, you know, Mads Larsen and Rudy Markussen. The fact that he's involved with Mikkel Kessler's former promoter, Morgan Spaller. These are all stories which make a promoter's job, of course, a lot easier. But if we move all that to the side, these are two great athletes. Brian McGee is someone who's come on very late in his career and has done the business, you know, like we saw in February against Rudy Markussen and knocking him out. So he's someone we definitely won't underestimate. Mikkel will always be the favorite in fights. We mustn't forget that. He's one of the greats. So, you know, it's going to be a very action-packed fight. I think Brian McGee is the type of boxer who will come here wanting to do a technical job. When I say that, he will come to box against Mikkel and look for the chance to unleash his left hook, which is a great shot, which took out Rudy Markussen. And you know, he'll be very confident. At the same time, we'll be very confident too.
And all the stories about the revenge for Mikkel after the knock after Brian McGee has been beating Mads Larsen and Rudy Markussen. How much is that a question of honor?
Well, I think there's a national team sort of atmosphere around this. You know, it's Brian McGee as an Irishman has come here and basically beaten up two Danes, knocked two Danes out, and you know, I think Mikkel does feel some sort of responsibility to restore the pride of Danish boxing, if you like. On the other side, it has also a big storyline in the fact that Mikkel is boxing for the world championship, something which he knows would be a record. You know, four times world champion is something very, very special.
But he's also getting older, and every time it might be his last fight. And people talk about this Karl Froch and this Andre Ward fights coming up. What is, if he loses now, is it his last fight, or is there still a few fights in him?
In boxing, you never say never. But I would say if Mikkel would lose the fight, I think it would be a very difficult future. You know, I don't know whether Mikkel would want to continue boxing. It's a question you have to ask him. I mean, he's, you know, we're happy to promote him, of course, afterwards. But I think that if he would lose, we would sit down and I think it could be the end of the day, yes.
So it's very important, not just to win, but also to win. And I mean, win in a style and a way that makes sure that he can continue.
Well, I think the question here is just to win. I mean, you know, Brian McGee is a world championship fight. You know, to the people who say, oh, Mikkel's getting older, well, why don't you ask Alan Green how he felt after the fourth round? You know, he just pulled off one of the knockouts that will probably go down as the knockout worldwide of this year. So, you know, Mikkel has to win. How he wins, to be honest with you, I don't really care. I want him to win and to become world champion. We're in a sport of winning. And, you know, December the 8th, that's the time for us to win.
This venue here, Herning and Jyskebank Boxing, it's not a place with a lot of history because it's very new and it's the first time for a professional boxing fight. What do you see this event as a venue for this fight?
Well, I see it as a great venue. It's a 10,000 plus seater. It's going to be full, you know, it'll be sold out, I think, pretty quickly. And I think it's going to have an atmosphere in here that will raise the roof. I mean, I remember the fights here against Perdomo and against Karl Froch, of course. Where the atmosphere was electric, and I'm expecting the same thing here. And you know, it is the first boxing fight in Jyskebank Boxing, and I think that's you know, it's a credit to them that they got the event here. They gave, you know, they made a real effort, and you know, I think we're very proud to basically christen the arena with boxing. It will be the first event, and I'm sure not the last.
Kalle Sauerland siger, at han glæder sig til at indvie arenaen her med boksning. Det gør du vel også?
Ej, det må man sige. Det er jo det, vi ligesom har ventet på at kunne få til at gå i opfyldelse. Arenaen her, Jyskebank Boxing, blev jo tænkt tilbage i 90'erne, hvor jeg var en tur i Rom og var inde i Colosseum og stod derinde og mærkede den der larmende stillhed. Og så frem til tiden i dag, hvor vi så får verdensklasse boksning herind. Det er vi rigtig, rigtig glade for. Det er jo tredje gang, Mikkel Kessler er her. Først var i den runde, som solgte godt ud, og der var et brag af en stemning. Så var han i Halem året efter, altså i 2010, i en historisk match mod Froch. Den tror jeg, vi alle kan huske, og altid vil huske. Og så skal vi så her i Jyskebank Boxing se Mikkel Kessler i en ny stor kamp, som helt klart vil danne stemning herinde, som vil kunne huskes også.
Og hvad er det, man kan forvente, som, hvis man kommer her altså som tilskuer? Der er højt til loftet og så videre. Altså, hvordan bliver det at være tilskuer til boksekampen her?
Jamen altså, vores multiarena her er bygget til unikke, store, spektakulære events. Og det er den kamp her jo. Og det, der hele tiden har været hele ideen, og også er DNA'en i hele den her konstruktion, det er stemningen for publikum, bliver det tilfælde her kastet ind mod ringen, og stemningen for og intensiteten inden for ringen, skal kastes ud til publikum, og det er det, jeg glæder mig rigtig allermest til at mærke den stemning, for vi har jo haft nogle enorme oplevelser ind allerede nu på de her snart 2 år, hvor Jyskebank Boxing har stået her. Og det har været top musik, top underholdning, det har været europamesterskaberne i håndbold, og nu skal vi så også have verdensklasse boksning. Det bliver dejligt.
Forventer du også, at der bliver udsolgt?
Det håber jeg på, for jeg tror på, at boksen her, den er stadigvæk ny for mange, og når vi bygger sådan noget her, så er det også fordi, vi mener det. Og da vi i sin tid skulle have lægge de her sigtelinjer ind, uden det bliver for teknisk. Men det er den måde, man fra tilskuerpladserne, uanset hvor man er herinde, ser ind mod enten scenen deroppe, eller ind mod midten, eller på banen. Nu bliver det så mod midten af ringen her. Så skal man kunne få en god oplevelse. Og det gælder både det, man ser, det, man føler, det, man mærker, og total oplevelsen. tror jeg også mange vil komme efter. Og så har vi jo en verdensklasse bokser og en fantastisk personlighed, Mikkel Kessler, som jeg personligt har den største respekt for, og nu også har lært at kende, fordi Mikkel heldigvis har været her allerede et par gange. Og nu er han tilbage igen, efter at have været lidt væk herfra. Men jeg kan mærke på Mikkel og på Kalle Sauerland, at de glæder sig, og det gør vi også.
Ja, han er jo lidt tabt op. Okay.
You've already been beating Mads Larsen and Rudi Markussen, and now you're facing Mikkel Kessler. What is it with you and Danes?
I guess just, I know I've been lucky here, so I have, and the Danish people seem to have, you know, just maybe, I think Denmark just breeds so many good super middleweight division, super middleweight here. Oh, sorry, just, I can start it again, can I?
Okay, yeah. Okay. You've already been beating Mads Larsen and Rudi Markussen, and now you're facing Mikkel Kessler. What is it with you and Danes?
Yeah, I think, well, it's just one of them things. There's so many good super middleweights here, and this is where you got to come to fight them. But Mikkel Kessler, he's a number one, so he is, and it's a tough fight. But it's two experiences have been fantastic so far. Hopefully the third one will be just as good, you know.
But you chose to fight Mikkel. You could have chosen an easier opponent, I reckon. Why did you choose Mikkel?
Well, when you just stand here in this amazing arena, you look around, there's my name in lights, fighting Mikkel Kessler. You know, if I had to choose to fight number 15 in the world, number 10 in the world, I wouldn't be standing in an arena like this here with my name in lights. You know, it would probably be some Mee Hall in some place, you know, down the road. So, you know, you want to be the big shows, you want to be big time boxing. These are the type of guys you got to fight. There's no easy fight for a world title. And, you know, this is where I want to be. I want to look back at my career, want to finish and say, yeah, I fought the best. And to have somebody like Mikkel Kessler on your record is a honor, like, for anybody, you know.
But it's also a matter of winning. How do you see your chances against Mikkel Kessler?
Yeah, as good as anybody. You know, I've come here twice, so I've no worries about coming here. But, you know, there's no easy fight with Mikkel Kessler. You know, he's a great boxer, he's a great fighter. He's got lots of heart. You know, you just gotta get in and fight. You know, maybe hope he has a bad night. You know, I have a great night. But it's you know, it's exciting, and that's what's exciting about boxing. You know, but you know, he was where I am right now. He was challenging for a world title at one stage like this, and now he's three times world champion. You know, I want to be world champion now, just where he was. He was at the stage at one time in his career, so why can't I be? You know, maybe another year, maybe where he is now. So you know, it's that kind of thing. You just gotta believe in yourself.
The last fight, Mikkel Kessler was performing a spectacular knockout, maybe the knockout of the year,
yeah,
against Alan Green. I think you have seen it already.
Yeah.
Are you afraid of facing Mikkel Kessler when he performs like that?
I mean, everybody has good nights, and you know, boxing, people get knocked out. It's once you accept that and accept the fear, you know what, you're fine. I mean, you know, if I didn't want stuff like that to happen, I would go and play at, you know, chess or something, or stuck to golf. So whatever, you know, but this is boxing, this is world championship boxing, and the idea is, you know, you go in to try and knock somebody out, and that's what happens. So, you know, it's nothing new, it's nothing I've never seen before, but you know, it was a fantastic knockout and a fantastic win for him. You know, he's in great form, but you know, what can you do? I've had some great knockouts, some great nights too, so you know, you just accept it, just move on, don't dwell on it, you know. Hopefully he doesn't repeat that on the 8th, but you know, I'll be there trying to knock him out as well at the same time.
So yeah, your tactic will be to go for a knockout?
No, you never go for a knockout. You hope it, you know, the old saying, if you go for a knockout, it never happens, you never get it. But just knockout usually just comes. But, you know, we're two good punchers in there. You know, Mikhail has a knockout punch. I have a good punch on me as well. So, like, you know, it's going to be exciting. It's going to be explosive. You know, it's looking like a great fight. So it is, all around.
All right.
Thank you. No worries. Yeah.
All right. I'll follow you on the...
You could have chosen other boxers to fight for this world championship, but you are choosing Mikkel Kessler. Why?
Well, it's not so much me choosing Mikkel Kessler as Brian McGee. We did have the choice of picking anyone in the top 15 of the WBA ratings, but Brian preferred to have a major fight, and as it turned out, it's a super fight. I mean, this is a super fight. Mikkel Kessler is a name known throughout the world. I do believe he's a superstar here in Denmark, and this is a fight that Brian's excited by. He wants it, and he's been here before. In the series against Denmark, we're 2-0 up,
Why not?
But it's also a very difficult fight. He could have chosen maybe an easier one.
Yes, but I mean, Brian is at the stage of his career where he wants to be the best in the world. He wants to prove he's the best in the world. And here we have Michael Kessler virtually on our doorstep. Why not? I mean, he knows Michael Kessler. He's confident he can beat him, and he wants his chance.
And what about all this talking about Mads Larsen, Rudi Markussen, and now it's the third time with a Danish opponent. What is it with you and Danes?
Well, it's not so much us and Danes. I mean, as it's happened, I mean, the two wins that we've had in Denmark, the win in Aarhus against Mads Larsen, the win in Copenhagen against Rudi Markussen, I mean, this has raised Brian's profile. We have gained enormous prestige out of those two fights, and this is a happy hunting ground for Brian. He feels comfortable here. I think he has Danish support here, and and this arena, magnificent arena, this will bring out the best in Brian. And I don't think we've seen the best in Brian, because he's been improving steadily, and you'll see more improvement on the night.
But still, I'm sure that most of the people in here will cheer for Michael Kessler when it comes to the fight night. So it will also be an away ground for him.
Well, I mean, Brian is you know, he's fought most of it. If you look at his record, most of his fights have been away. He won't be fazed by fighting away from home. And he will have comfort from the fact that he'll have a lot of support from home. We will bring a lot of supporters. They'll be heard in the crowd. But at the end of the day, it's a fight between Brian and Michael Kessler. When the bell rings, forget about who's in the hall. Forget about who's got the support. It's the two guys head to head.
Super.
Okay, thanks very much.